Two former U.S. soldiers were part of what Venezuela says was a plan to overthrow President Nicolas Maduro. They were part of a group of around 60 people that say they were hoping to help Venezuelans regain freedom. But the plan did not work out. Eight of them were killed and at least 13 others detained when they tried to reach the Venezuelan coast in a speedboat. On Wednesday, Nicolas Maduro gave a press conference where he showed the video of interrogation of one of the former U.S. soldiers involved.
My responsibilities to Silver Corps.
There he explained his job was to train Venezuelans and help them take control of the airport in Caracas. Maduro once again blamed Donald Trump, Colombia's President Iván Duque, and opposition leader Juan Guaidó for the plot to oust him. The three of them have denied involvement.
Who organized this mercenary and terrorist incursion that wanted to fill Venezuela with violence? Who did it? Who gave the order? Who financed it? These are the answers we are getting every day.
He also showed a contract that was allegedly signed by Guaidó and Jordan Gourdeau, a U.S. war veteran that owns Silver Corp, the security company hired for the failed military operation. Maduro said he would request his extradition from the United States and that the captured Americans would be tried in Venezuela. U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo said he would do everything in his power to secure their release.
We're going to work on this. It's a consular matter in the sense of anytime there are Americans that are detained someplace, we'll work to get them back. We will start the process of trying to figure a way if in fact these are Americans that are there, that we can figure a path forward.
It's not the first time Venezuela accuses the U.S. of supporting plans to get Maduro out of office. It's been used as a smokescreen to cover the many problems Venezuelans face today. But the detention of two U.S. former soldiers in the country raised questions about who was behind a plot that most analysts say was doomed from the start. Teresa, Al Jazeera.